Okay, guys, this is Algebra 1. We're going to work in Chapter 2. Okay, we're working Chapter 2, and today we're going to do Section 2.1. Okay, and that's called Writing and Graphing Inequalities. Okay, so you should be taking notes on this. Okay, your sub will be checking to see that you have these notes. That counts as your assignment. So it is important that you have this. Make sure that you copy and do the problems as I read them to you, and that when we do have the problems and I pause the video, that you're doing them. That's how you're gonna get something out of this. Okay, we work together, we can make this work. Okay, so here are our goals for this lesson. We want to, number one, write linear inequalities. Okay, write linear inequalities. And number two, we want to sketch the graphs of linear inequalities. Graph linear inequalities. Okay, and then finally, we want to write linear inequalities from graphs. Put them together. Put the two things together. Write linear inequalities from graphs. Okay, so that's what we're looking at today. Okay, that's what we're looking at. So I'm hopeful that you guys are paying attention, or we're following along, listening to the sweet sounds of Taylor Swift in the background. That's what I did for a lot of my videos in the last year was we were in COVID, so I figured we'd go back to it, all right? So, inequalities. What is an inequality? Well, there's four types. Okay, there's four types. That one there is read as less than. This one here is read as greater than. Okay, and then if we have a line underneath it, okay, you have a line underneath it, you're gonna have less than or equal to. And then if it looks like this with a line underneath it, we're gonna say that's greater than or equal to. Okay, so that's how we're getting started. Okay, we're talking about inequalities. When you see a symbol like that, it's called less than. When you see a symbol like that, it's called greater than. If it has a line underneath it, it's also less than or equal to. It's greater than or equal to. Okay, now on top of all that, okay, on top of all that, there's an important chart that I'm going to give you, okay? Because sometimes when you're reading these, they're not just going to say less than. They might say at most, more than. They're going to use different words there. So I really think that it's going to be important that you have this chart in your notes so you can refer to it when we're doing practice problems in class, or if you're doing problems for homework, okay? So again, Let's go through the symbols, okay? So here, this one here, okay? That is less than, okay? You might also see something where it says is fewer than. And I guess I probably should say is less than. So let's take this one out of play. And let's go back again, okay? Is less than. Okay, and then we're also going to say is fewer than. Okay, when you have this one here, well, we know that one is greater than. Okay, is greater than. And then you could also say it is more than. Okay, so we have is less than, is fewer than, is greater than, is more than. All right? Now, we've also got these here. Okay? This one here is less than or equal to, is less than or equal to. And then there's a couple other ones, okay? You might see something where it says is at most, okay? Or is no more than. If you see any of those terms, okay? If you see any of those terms, that means less than or equal to, okay? And that symbol goes with that. So then we have this one here, and we know that one looks like is greater than or equal to, is greater than or equal to. You could say it is at least, or you could say it is no less than. Again, I really just think it's important to have this, okay? I think it's important to have in your notes. That way you can refer to it, because they're not gonna just say is less than or is less than or equal to. They're gonna throw different words in there, okay? And as you can see here, there's no at most, no more than, no less than, at least. And we'll go over them and it'll make sense as we go through it, okay? So our first job is going to be to take some of these terms and write inequalities for them, okay? So the first one is a number. A number W minus 3.5 is less than or equal to negative 2. Okay, so write that down. A number W minus 3.5 is less than or equal to a negative 2. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna take this and we're gonna look, when we look at it, it's like translating something from another language. If you were to translate something from English to Spanish or Spanish to English or French or whatever language you're looking at, you take the words and you try to figure out what they mean, okay? What do they mean and how do you write that? How do you interpret that? Okay, so let's look. So it says a number W. Well, I'm gonna put W. And then it says minus 3.5, okay? Minus 3.5 is less than or equal to negative 2. So sometimes what you have to do here is you have to kind of read through it, you know, if you read through it and it might make more sense, okay? It might make more sense to you. So that's our first one, okay? That's our first one. Here's another one. So it says, 3 is less than a number n plus 5. If you want to pause the video and give that a shot and see if you can come up with the right answer, that'd be great. Okay, pause that video, try to write down what you think the inequality would be, and then we'll take a look and I'll put the answer down and we'll see if we get the same thing. Okay, so I'm hoping that you pause the video and that's how you're gonna get something out of this, okay? If you're just going through the motions, listening to the video, not taking the notes and just doing the problems, well, good luck to you in high school. That's what I would tell you. Okay, I'm hoping that you're stopping and you're doing the problems and you're actually attempting these, because that's how you can get better at it. So let's see. 3 is less than a number. 3. How do I say is less than a number? Well, I think I would say it that way. 3 is less than a number, okay, a number n plus 5. And there's the inequality. Okay, that's our inequality for our second one. Let's go on to the next one. Zero is greater than or equal to twice a number x plus 1. So pause the video, give it a shot. See what you get. Okay, so I'm hoping you pause the video or come back and take a look at this and see if we can figure it out. So it says zero, well I know what zero is, I can put that down. Is greater than or equal to, so that's the next thing I've gotta do. That's gonna be this symbol here. Twice a number x plus 1. Twice a number x. That's like saying 2 times x. Okay? And I'd make it like this. Now, someone will say, well, how do you know there's no parentheses there? How do you know you don't have parentheses around the x plus 1? And the only reason you would put parentheses around the x plus 1 if they put the word sum in there. If they had the word sum, the sum of twice a number and x, then you would have parentheses. But otherwise, this is the way we do it. Zero is greater than or equal to twice a number x plus 1. Okay? So I've got a couple more that I want you guys to try. I'm going to write them down, and what I'd like you to do is I'd like you to write them as an inequality. Pause the video and give it a shot. Okay? So there's one. There's the other. So please, please, please pause that video, okay? Pause the video and try those problems. Okay, so hopefully you're back, hopefully you're following along and you're doing what I ask. I can't be there to watch over you, okay? So my hope is that that's what you're doing. That's how you're gonna get something out of us, and you're gonna say you learned something, give you a good grade on that MCAS score and get you set up well for high school. So a number C plus 9.4 is greater than or equal to a negative 6. And there's my answer. Okay, next one. 6 is greater than a number P. 6 is greater than a number P minus 8. Okay, again, so we just take it piece by piece. You go down the list, you interpret the words, you know, it's just like taking it from a different language. When someone said, how do I say good morning or some phrase in Spanish, you break it down word by word. And that's what we're trying to do here. Okay, that's the goal. So that's the first part of what we're looking at. Now, the next part we're going to transition into is when they talk about a solution to an inequality. Okay? A solution of an inequality is a value that makes the inequality true. Okay, so if they have an inequality and they give you a value, and the value makes the inequality true, then that's a solution. It's a solution to the inequality. Okay. Now, my handwriting is not good. I'm going to tell you that right now, and it's not going to get better. It's only going to get worse. So if there's anything that you have a hard time with, you can always go back in the video and listen to it again. And hopefully that's helpful to you. So that's what a solution is. A solution of inequality is a value that makes the inequality true. Okay? And if they said the set of all solutions of an inequality, that would be a solution set. So a solution set would be the set of all solutions. Set of all solutions for an inequality. Okay? So the next part we're going to have is they're going to ask you a question. And they're going to say something like, tell whether -4 is a solution of the inequality. So they give us an inequality. The first one's going to be x + 8 is greater than 3. Okay? So what I have to do here, well, what do you guys think I have to do? Think about what would you do in this situation? If you're looking to tell whether it's a solution to the inequality. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that -4, I'm going to substitute it in for x. I'm going to plug it in for x. The -4 is going to take the place of the x. And then I'm going to evaluate it, and I'm going to try to see if it's a solution to the inequality, if it makes a true statement. So let's look. -4 + 8, is that greater than 3? -4 + 8 is 4. Is 4 greater than 3? Yes. So therefore, yes, it is a solution. -4 is a solution. Okay? What if I had this? I guess I should put the variable in there. I kind of gave that one away. -3 × -4 would be 12. Is less than -20. The answer to that's no. But I got to start off with a variable. It's my mistake. I'll say -4 × x is greater than 21. So we got to take that -4 and we got to plug it in. Okay, so you have -4 × -4 and see if that's greater than 21. -4 × -4 is a positive 16. Is 16 greater than 21? No. So therefore, it is not a solution. Okay, not a solution. So here's one for you guys to try. Tell whether 3 is a solution, okay, x - 7 is greater than -5, -3x is less than or equal to -12.5. All right, guys, give it a shot. See what you think. Okay, x - 7 is greater than -5. And -3x is less than or equal to -12.5. Pause the video, okay, pause the video, and plug that in and see if you think that they are solutions to the inequality. Okay, so I'm hoping you pause that video. Again, it's not gonna do us much good if you're not. So let's take a 3 and plug it in. So you're going to have 3 - 7 is greater than a -5. Well, let's look. I don't know. 3 - 7. 3 - 7 is a -4. Is -4 greater than a -5? Yeah, -4 is bigger than a -5. So we would say, is this a solution? Yes. Yes, it is a solution. Okay?